I am Chris Gabehart. I'm the crew chief for number 11 FedEx Toyota Camry for Joe Gibbs Racing. My family's been in it a long time. My grandfather, Al Straub, actually raced in the early years of NASCAR. I got my first start at an organized level at about 10 years old, go-kart racing. My mom and dad both were very heavily involved. So we would all travel, did that for several years, got several World Karting Association national championships as a driver. From a very young age, they were pushing the importance of developing a career and versatility and how important education was. That was my passion with racing. It's what I wanted to do. I wanted to drive at the time. But it was very logical for me at that point to consider, hey, race cars are heavily engineering based. Mechanical engineering, perfect. And Purdue was the obvious choice from that point of view. For racing cars, mechanical engineering covers the broadest aspect of what we do. So you look at thermodynamics and heat transfer and the dealings of what we do with this energy when we make it and how it's expelled. Well, that's a major part of racing, right? Many, many lectures where I was like, wow, that is gonna help me in racing, and it has. For me, what school was about more than anything, I didn't realize it at the time, was teaching me how to think and teaching me how to go about solving problems. And what I do here, you don't always 100% know the answer. If you did, all 40 cars would be competing for a win today. I was also juggling this driving career, and I drove all the way up to about 2009 and then kind of morphed my way into the business side of things and figuring out how to make a stable living doing it. I've become pretty good acquaintances with Tom Bush, who is Kyle Bush's dad. Kyle took a liking to the things that I did for his late model team. He moved me up to his truck team for a year. I was an engineer on his truck team. And then in 2012, I made the move to Joe Gibbs Racing as an engineer on his cup car. Yes, it's on a different stage, but it's, as Tom always liked to tell me, hey, Chris, they're still race cars. They got four tires and the driver sits to the left of the drive shaft. They're the same from the beginning to even on this bigger stage. So while the tools and the resources and the people management side of things are much bigger than I had spent my whole career doing, it was a role that I quickly came comfortable in and enjoyed the challenge of it. What's so awesome about working for Joe Gibbs Racing and having Denny Hamlin as a driver is my support network is huge. Denny's not a rookie, he's a seasoned pro. He knows what he needs in his race cars, he's very confident. And then Joe Gibbs Racing with their management staff and leadership group and resources they have and Toyota, I really had a huge support network around me. So it allowed me to really compartmentalize and focus on the 11 team and the logistics of the weekend and just making sure we tick all the boxes we need to throughout the week in terms of preparation.
One lap to go, chasing Hamlin and Bush.
Denny Hamlin.
Hamlin off turn number four. No, side-by-side battle to the finish this time. Denny Hamlin wins his second Daytona 500.
Wow.
What a day for J.D. Gibbs, for Joe Gibbs, for that whole team. Boy, that's storybook stuff right there.
That was meant to be.
The neat part of the Daytona win is while I do have such a huge support network around me, strategy did come into play. I was able to make some aggressive calls, and Denny, you know, really trusted me and my ability to do it. And together we put ourselves back in position and we were able to win that race. And I was very fortunate, very fond memories of that. And then, but really it was about Denny Hamlin and Joe Gibbs Racing that weekend. I was just the lucky recipient.
You got to give a shout out to the new crew chief, Chris Gabehart. He has stepped into that position and it is pressure filled, and he has really helped this team along. Denny has a lot of confidence in him, and that says a lot about Chris Gabehart.
I hold Purdue and its education that it's given me in such high regard, and obviously so does the country. The mechanical engineering school is ranked very highly, so graduating with a mechanical engineering degree at Purdue is the hardest thing I've ever done. And I say that proudly because they pushed me so hard to succeed at something that I wasn't very good at while balancing so many other things. And once I left Purdue, I realized that there wasn't a mountain I couldn't climb if I didn't set my mind to it. And it is the biggest reason I'm here today, no doubt about it.